coming up next, it's a bantamweight clash between Aljamain Sterling and TJ Dillashaw.
You ready? Let's go.
Round one is upon us between two of the best fighters in this division. Hard to find anything resembling a glaring weakness on either side when you break down.
There are no weaknesses in these guys. These guys are as well-rounded as they come. They both can wrestle, both can grapple, both can strike. They can do it all. And these are the matchups that we dream of as MMA fans.
Oh, really using his reach advantage there with that land, DC.
Big body kick land.
Timing his shots pretty well.
Oh! He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad. Oh, look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom. The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
But now DC trying to isolate an arm.
Yep, he's using the Kimura.
And he's out. Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. Dillashaw gets up, but he looks dazed. He looks confused.
Ooh, big shot land.
Dillashaw's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. So just over 20 total strikes, as you see there, have landed for Aljamain Sterling. Good defense to block the strike coming back. He's in a world of trouble now.
They say the straight feet are the ones that get there first, and they got right.
That is it.
They got him.
Again, the winner here was so aggressive.